In this lecture, we will address keywords related to test process topic. And these are the keywords which we are going to cover in this lecture because they are related to the upcoming topics. Few I will cover now, and remaining will cover while addressing the topic. These are the 8 keywords you must know before we go to the test process topic. All the definitions provided here are given by ISTQB itself. Along with the definition, I will provide some real examples for easy understanding of these terms. So let's start with the keywords. First keyword is test basics, and it is defined as the body of knowledge used as the basis for test analysis and design. In simple terms, test basis is nothing but the requirement. Let's see an example to understand this. Suppose this is the requirement. We need a light system which will glow when door is open and close when door is closed. The system shall work like mentioned. This is a requirement which we need to test, and it is refined as test basics. Now let's see the second keyword, test condition, and it is defined as a testable aspect of a component or system identified as a basis for testing. Let's refer to the same example to find out testable aspect of the requirement. The testable aspects are, first, light shall glow when door is open. Second, light shall not glow when door is closed. After reading the test basics, we got this as a testable condition. Next keyword is test case, and it is defined as a set of preconditions, inputs, actions where applicable, expected results and postconditions developed based on test conditions. In simple words, test cases are set of actions to test the test condition. Let's continue with our example to understand this point. Now, to check these test conditions, we can write 2 test cases as shown here. Test case 1 is, first, switch on power, second, open door, 3, check light on, 4, switch off power. And test case 2 is, first, switch on power, second, close door, third, check light off, fourth, switch off power. Action to test test condition is called test cases. The next keyword is test procedure, and it is defined as a sequence of test cases in execution order and any associated actions that may be required to set up the initial preconditions and any wrap-up activities post-execution. This term is used mostly when you go for manual testing, where you decide in which order test cases to be executed, or if any precondition or post-conditions are required. Now, let's have a look into test case 1. After the test case is executed, the door shall be closed and light to be switched off. Similarly, for test case 2, during initial condition, the door shall be open and light must be on so that we can see the change. Next keyword is test data, and it is defined as data needed for test execution. This term is used during the automation testing. While executing the test case, we need test data. Let's see the sample data to understand this point. In the test case, we are saying switch on power supply, but we didn't mention how much voltage shall be provided. This data we will get from test data. Similarly, all other values with respect to test cases are stored. These data can be stored in Excel form or any testing-specific tools. Let's move to the next keyword, that is test suite, and it is defined as a set of test scripts or test procedures to be executed in a specific test run. Test scripts mean a set of instructions for the execution of a test. By using test case as a reference, test scripts are developed. These test scripts are then arranged in the execution order as shown here. That's why we can say a group of test scripts with a sequence of instructions is called suite. Next keyword is testware. It is defined as work products produced during the test process for use in planning, designing, executing, evaluating, and report on testing. As we know, we have different activities in test process like test planning, test monitoring, test analysis, test design, test implementation, test execution, and test closure. Each of these activities provide output, and these outputs are called testware. Testware are stored for each testing phase for future reference. Last key point is test oracle, and it is defined as a source to determine an expected result to compare with the actual result of the system under test. As the definition says, test oracle stores expected result, which is compared against the measured result during test execution. These were the 8 keywords which we covered here, and it will be very helpful for you as we cover the following topics. Thank you.